Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome back to American Life Farming. We finished harvesting oat from field 33, the field that we bought before our previous episode when we bought the sheep farm. We borrowed some money from the bank and we bought this baler, the John Deere baler. It was pretty cheap, John Deere 690, and we bought that Peterbilt truck and the auto load trailer. We're using Follow Me so we can do all of this at once. We're gonna pay attention to the truck and the trailer. When it becomes full, we're gonna have to drive it back at the farm and put the bales into our storage under the cover and place them in a shed. That trailer can hold up to 39 bales, so it's helping us quite a bit. It was not that expensive, 56,000, something like that. Not really expensive at all. If you think about it, it's using auto load. Not that realistic, maybe, but we have a lot of bales pick up and take back to the farm, so we're gonna do that. It kind of helping us hurrying this process up. I did look again in the weather menu and it looks like tonight we're gonna have rain. Starts at midnight and pretty much the entire day tomorrow we're gonna have rain, so we need to gather all these straws and take them under cover so we don't lose the straws or the bales. So that's the plan for just now. Let's see what we can do after we finish this task. Our rice on field 35, it's still growing, so at least we don't need to hurry and harvest that crop. Hopefully there's gonna be a small window in between the rains where we can actually do some harvesting. Let's take a look for just a moment and see. Yeah, tomorrow is pretty much raining all day long. And let's take a look at the rice. We still have a few good days for us. 7 days, 7 more days when we can have the harvest for the rice. Sunflower, 6 days. Harvesting season for sunflower haven't started it yet, so at least there's a good way for us to just finish the rice first. So we're pretty lucky in regards to that. I'm just messing up the corner a little bit, but not losing that many straws. We're gonna have quite a few amount of straw bales. Let's watch the truck for a second, pick that up without any issues, and it's probably full, or at least close to full. I think, let's take a look. Yeah, it's now gonna pick that up, so that means it's full. We need to drive it over at the farm, unload into a shed. I just follow me, and it's an old truck. It came really cheap. I don't believe it's a mod that is modified by Stevie. It's not, obviously it's not in the base game. Let me slow down for this turn right here. And one more turn, going right. We're heading over to the farm. I have no idea where to place all these bales. I'm not sure if they're gonna fit into that shed where we have the hay bales. Speaking of hay bales, that reminds me that we need to mow the grass on field 11 as well, and that grass into hay. At least we bought the baler and we own it. It's ours. We don't have to return it. We didn't lease it. We just bought it. Came in really cheap. And it's a John Deere baler, so it's one more green equipment on the farm. But for now, let's see. Let us find the best place for us to put all these bales. Let's head on over this way. Let's not run over. I don't know what happened there with our sunflower. I know I didn't run over. Harvested, yeah, there's no way we harvested our sunflower. It's still growing. I don't know what's that all about, but doesn't matter. Let's just see if we can fit these bales into the shed. I'm worried that the trailer is longer than the shed is. Let me just try to go a little bit closer to the left side. No, I said left side. Well, the truck left side, not ours, the way we're looking now. I don't even know if I can. Let's go into. Okay, let's go with select the location with our big key. It's not gonna fit in, unfortunately. But maybe we can just unload into the back. Okay, it looks like it's gonna work, unloading into the back. And it's gonna be a few bales that we need to move from outside into the inside. Not that many, looks like just a couple of bales, but we did it. We managed to unload our first trailer of bales. So what we're gonna do next is just drive back over at field 33. Looks like we're gonna do this for the most part of the night. It's 9 o'clock and like I said, the rain starts at midnight or close to midnight. So we need to make sure we at least bale that entire field before the rain starts. Hopefully we are gonna be able to hold most of the bales back in cover before the rain starts. Would you just hurry up? Let's overtake that truck, head on over back into the field. We'll set follow me again, which we just paid $171 for using driver to follow us. Not that expensive. We do have 97,000 into our bank account, but we have a bigger loan than that. I'm gonna show you guys in just a moment. But for now, let's make sure we said follow me first. We will follow our tractor. Okay. You. Yeah, that's the key. And it's following our tractor. So let's jump in. Start everything. And keep on bailing. Okay. Not the way I wanted to do it, but since I went this way, I'm gonna go with this small headland pass right here, and then we're gonna go up and down the field. I'm gonna have to make sure that our truck is following us the right way. Obviously, at the end, when we first started doing this, just now, after we came back from the farm, we were not really turning the right way. It looks like he missed one bale, that's fine. Make sure we pick that one later. We'll just make sure it's not gonna miss more than one bale. Looks like it missed one bale right here also. And then going way too wide on that turn. But anyway, I'm gonna keep on doing this. There's no point in having you guys watch me turn all this field into bales and hold them back at the farm. It's gonna be way too painful, painful for you guys to just watch me do this. Looks like a truck driver is probably had too much to drink. I don't know what that's all about. Going all the way left and right. But like I was saying, let me finish this field, this work, this task, and I'll see you guys in just a moment. And we are back. What a beautiful morning it is. In fact, the morning sucks, but it doesn't matter. Lucky for us, our rice is still not ready to harvest, and I'm just about to flip my truck over. We have made a few bales that are the big ones. I do have a mod installed that will change the amount of the straws that you can put in a bale. So we have 20,000 liters bales, big ones. I have no idea if that's gonna give us any money, but it did. We're looking at probably $22,000 out of the bales. Let's check real quick. Sold bales, $22,000. And we just bought fertilizer for $9,600. We're filling completely with fertilizer. And let's see, where do I want to send this truck? Back to the farm, I think. And we are right now in our smaller John Deere, the ones that we using to fertilize the fields. Pretty much all we use this tractor for, and some work around the farm. Like we've been used this tractor for feeding our cows. We got a front loader attached. Well, we can attach a front loader on this tractor, so that's why we're using this one. It was not the best day for us to sell the straws, but I had no more place where I can store them, so they will stay safe. Let's take a look. Our rice not ready to be harvested. Our sunflower also not ready to harvest. And okay, let's start this tractor. It's going to circle around just for a little bit, and I don't want that. We do have a contract that we just accepted for field 40 fertilizing job. Let's make sure we're spraying, and it's gonna pay us $19,106. Decent money for a fertilizing job. I like fertilizing job. They paid pretty much the best. They go side by side with harvesting jobs, I think. But with harvesting contracts, it depends on how much crops you get left after you finish the contract, what kind of crops there is, so how much money you can get from selling the crops. Playing with seasons also has an impact. If you sell the crops right away for a lower price than you can actually get. But I do like fertilizing job. We have done a lot of fertilizing contracts on this field, on Yeah, I'm pretty much on this field as well, but on this map, they paid better than any other jobs. And I kind of like fertilizing job. They don't take as long as sowing jobs or cultivating jobs. Let me try to set GPS on this field. So we have it working. Let's say the width, it's at 9.14 meters and we need it to be at 30 meters for the width of the sprayer that we're using. And we're just gonna finish spraying this field. Obviously it's gonna take a minute. I don't think we are gonna be seeing it in, I don't know, what's with that corner that we've seen on this field. Let's set GPS again so we can take a look. Not sure why this is all yellow, orange color when the rest of the field is green. Maybe this is the part we missed spraying when we did a fertilizing job earlier on this field. Not sure though. Doesn't really matter either. It's not our field. We're gonna do this, complete the contract, we're gonna get paid and mind our own business. There's a harvesting job on field 3 that I wanted to start, but since it's raining I'm not gonna start that. If we, let me just turn around and take a look. Let's start GPS back again so we can take a look at something else. So if we borrow the equipment, is 1700, not that expensive. We could probably do that. We're not losing all that much money, but it's raining so we cannot do any harvesting job. Let's check again. It wants us to harvest barley, and barley harvesting season for barley ends tonight, and if we can't finish the job by midnight, we're gonna lose the contract and everything we worked is gonna be gone. It's gonna be just a waste of time and our effort. So I'm not gonna start that contract. Maybe in time there's gonna be some other contracts that are paying that good, hopefully better crops. Let's check on barley real quick. All the prices, all the sell points are dropping in prices in for barley. The best price at this moment is 480. So even if we sell the crop that we are gonna be left after we finish the contract, it's not gonna be that much if we sell it right away. If we're careful and we stop unloading when just at a time when we finished the contract, we can put all that barley into our silo and wait for a better price. But like I said, it's raining. I know that today is gonna be raining for most of the day, so I'm just gonna skip that contract and hope for better ones. Take a look at the ones we're currently working on. We're at 65% done with this contract. So let me hurry up and finish this field and I'll see you guys in a moment. And we are back everyone. It's a brand new morning and this time it really is a beautiful morning. Our rice is ready to harvest, so we can do that. We cannot drop straws from the rice that we're harvesting. That's fine, we have enough straw bales for now for our cows. We actually did manage to sell a few bales. And what we are going to do now, obviously, it's harvesting this field. Taking a look at the contracts, there is absolutely no contract that I really want to start doing, so that's great. If we ignore the contracts, we just realize that our sunflowers on 4 out of our 5 fields that we planted with sunflower, there those 4 fields are ready to harvest as well. I did pay some of the money back to the bank. We still have $50,000 on the loan. We're not gonna worry about that right now. I just wish I didn't pay it, because we're gonna have to take a loan again from the bank, because we do need to have to buy the corn header for us in order to be able to harvest the sunflower that we have in our fields. So we're gonna take back the loan that we paid, buy the header, and after we finish this field, we finish harvesting our rice, we're gonna move over back at the farm, back at the original farm, and we are gonna start harvesting our sunflower. We are at 50% full on the combine already. It looks like we're getting a pretty decent yield out of this field, out of the rice. Maybe we can plant. I don't think it's gonna work in the season menu, in the rotation menu. I'm not really sure if it's gonna work if we go with rice after oat. They're both cereals, and the yield is gonna drop quite a lot. Onion, we can do it. I don't want to do onion. That's something why I'm not gonna worry about right now, because we don't need to worry about that basically until next year. Of course, we're gonna plan before next year. We're gonna start planning and see what's best for us to put on the ground, in the ground. But we're not just gonna worry about that for now. We just need to worry about finishing harvesting this field. Obviously, it's gonna take a while until we're gonna be able to do that. Okay, let's go turn around. Let me check the shape of this field. Yeah, I think going north, heading south is gonna be the best option. I think it's longer north going south than east or west going east. So we are at 80% full on the combine. One thing I forgot to mention to you guys is that we do have our John Deere tractor, our newest addition. We have it at, we had a cultivator attached on field 33. We started cultivating that field. We need to plan ahead and not just leave it for tomorrow, because tomorrow it's going to be pretty busy, to be honest. So it's better if we start working on a field, then move on to another field that we clear, and so on and so on. Almost full now, and we are at 100%. Just curious if our tractor can fit in. Should not, that tree should not be in its way. Let us stop the engine. Let us jump into our tractor. We have both our trailers here in case we're gonna need both of them. My plan is to fill this one up and then unhook it and hook the other one up, fill that one. It's a shame that we cannot use both at the same time. It would have been so much easier. And we're gonna see if it's worth it to just do it like that. We'll have an auto drive driver chasing us onto the field and then taking the rice back at the silo. But we will see about that just a bit later on. We're gonna decide that why we go about harvesting. We're gonna have a look, see which way is gonna be better. And for now, I'm just gonna go with one headland pass. It should be more than enough. Then, like I said, we're gonna go from south heading north or from north heading south. Same thing, but I guess it's different in how people are saying it. Just a beautiful thing, isn't it? Let's check the price on rice since we're here. Not that much different in prices. Obviously, day first in summer it's offering the best price, but day four in fall it's not that further away. So maybe we can sell our rice in 3 days. We'll consider it and see what's going to be best for us. And we are unloading for the second time. Our combine is full again, and it looks like the yield on rice on this field is pretty good. Let me show you guys what I managed to harvest so far. Just 3 sides, like headland pass on just 3 sides, and then I used GPS and head north from this corner of the field. I didn't even manage to get to reach the end of the field, and we got full again. So it looks like there's gonna be a lot of rice from this field. That's obviously a good thing. Let me try to find rice. It's just here. Price is going down from 512, so we need to wait obviously before we start selling our rice. I just hope we can fit all this rice in our silo. Our silo can hold 500,000 liters, if I'm not mistaken. Yep, 500,000. Let's start with this part right here. Yeah, so I have reached the other corner of the field, the one on the southeast corner, and I forgot to turn the header on. It looks like I just lowered it. So I was driving like a maniac in full speed. We just threw in a little bit of the crops. Luckily we stopped in time. We didn't manage to lose that much crop. But I'm gonna fix this corner right here. There's this corner right here that I'm gonna fix. And then we're obviously gonna go up and down the field until we are gonna reach this corner, the northwestern part of the field. But anyway, I'm gonna end this episode here, guys. We're gonna pick things up from right here where we left off. We're gonna be harvesting this field on our next episode. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please consider subscribing. It will help the channel grow a lot. And like I always say, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you on our next episode.